Next, now cross this snap node and beam. Now see, this is our column layout. So this is our x direction and this is our z direction. So first of all, we'll take this node. So take here, put the zero. So one node show here. So select the node cursor and select this and simply Ctrl C and Ctrl V. Now how much distance here? We'll put z direction, that is 5.75 meter and this is 5.7 meter. So first put 5.75 meter. Okay. Now copy this node and we'll create another node z direction, that is 5.7 meter. So Ctrl C, Ctrl V, 5.7 meter. Okay. Now three node show here. Now we'll create x direction node. So how much distance? The first distance 4.758. So Ctrl C, Ctrl V, that is x direction 4.758. Okay. Now see, same way, now we'll create the node, this node. Assuming this column is not here, so we'll take these three column reference of these three nodes. So this distance 5.182, this is 5.128. So create first this grid. So for this, controls, copy this node, Ctrl C, Ctrl V, that is x direction 5.182. Okay. Same way, copy this node, Ctrl C, Ctrl V, then x direction 5.128. Okay, same way, copy this node, Ctrl C, Ctrl V, that is 4.876. Once again, copy, Ctrl C, Ctrl V, 5.185. Same way, Ctrl C, Ctrl V, 4.981. Now x direction node also taken. Now see this column and this column is not taken. So what we'll do, we'll take this column reference of this column. So this distance 2.465, that is x direction, and this column 2.504, that is z direction. So let's go. So take node cursor, Ctrl C, Ctrl C, Ctrl V, that is 2.465. Same way, select this node, Ctrl C, Ctrl V, that is z direction 2.504 meter. Okay. Now all column node show here. So select this node and select all node, and what we'll do, we'll connect all node by beam. So go to geometry and connect beam along x axis. 19 members are created. Okay. Same way, select geometry connect beam along z axis. Now 15 members are created. Okay, now select all beam and go to transitional repeat, and we'll create our ground for roof. So go to y direction and see our height, ground for height, how much here. This is 3.825, but 152 millimeter is rise. So this value minus this value, so our ground for height will be 3.673. So put here 3.673 and link step. Okay, now see our ground for roof beam connected. Now see our lower level beam is not required here, so delete this beam. Okay, now we draw our sub beam. So let's see the sub beam layout. So here 1, 2, 3 beam sub beam provided in z direction, sorry, x direction. Same way 1, 2, 3 sub beams provided x direction. So now go to top view and select this beam, and also we select one beam here. So go to connect this beam, and what we'll do, this distance how much, 2.465. so select this node, control C, control V, that is z direction, sorry, x direction, 2.465. okay, now connect these two node by add beam. Okay, now go to top view, we select this beam and control select this beam. Now go to insert node and add endpoint 3. Okay, now see here show the node. So what we'll do, we'll connect this node by add beam. So select node, this one, control node, this one, and geometry connect beam along x axis. 30 members are created. Okay, now our sub beam is drawn. Now here another portion, this is our stair portion, so connect this beam. So what we'll do, this distance how much, 2.504. so go to isometric view and select this node, control C, control V, that is z direction, 2.504. now see one node is here, so simply connect this top view, head beam, this one and this one. Now see here our sub beam, this distance and this distance same. So what we'll do, how much distance here, this is 1.4375. so select this beam, control C, control V, that is z direction but reverse direction, that means provide minus 1.4375. okay, let's see our isometric. Sorry, one mistake here. So delete this beam. So connect at this node and this node. Now it's okay. Go to top view and isometric view. Now our sub beam are connected. Now what we'll do, we'll draw our sphere. So go to Z view and select this portion and control select this portion and right button click new view. Okay, now go to isometric view. Now we'll draw first this sphere. Now assuming our first step will start from like this here, assuming this distance from this node to 1.5 meter, that is Z direction and reverse direction. So what we'll do, we take this node, control C, control V, that is minus 1.5 meter. Okay. And our first landing will rest on half of the column height. So select this beam and this beam and insert node at midpoint. Okay, now we connect this node by beam, this node and this node. Now we also this landing width is 1.5 meter. So select this beam, control C, control V, that is Z direction, 1.5 meter. Okay, now select this beam and insert node and add midpoint. Okay, now how much distance here? 1.2325. So we'll take another node. So select this, sorry, select this node, control C, control V, that is X direction, 1.2325. Okay, now what we'll do, this incline beam will rest on this intermediate beam. So and this beam will inside of this column, assuming this distance 0.2 meter. And one thing, this beam is not required, so because we provide here one intermediate beam here, so delete this beam and take this node cursor and select this node and this node, control C, control V, that is X direction, 0.2 meter. Okay, same way, select this node and this node, control C, control V, that is reverse direction, minus 0.2 meter. Now we'll draw our inclined beam. So take this node, and this node. Same way, this node, this node, this node to this node. Now this is our first step and first landing. Now same way, this inclined beam will connect this intermediate beam to ground floor roof. So what we'll do, we'll select this beam, this one, this one, this one and this one, and go to generate mirror and node on plane, click and take this node and go to YZ direction. Okay, now see this beam also go downward, but we need this beam upward. So what we'll do, select this beam, control select this beam, same as previous, generate mirror node, select as previous node and this beam is not required here. So what we'll do, we will remove it. So move, and that is XZ direction. So click, select XZ direction and OK. Now see, this beam is upward. Now what we'll do, assuming this beam second landing here also, assuming that landing width also 1.5 meter, that is Z direction and reverse direction. So what we'll do, select this beam, Control C. First of all, take this insert node, insert node at midpoint. Okay, now what we'll do, we'll take one, we'll create second landing here. So what we'll do, first of all, select this beam and take insert node and add new point, sorry, add midpoint. Okay, now select this node, and this node. We'll copy and paste this direction, that is Z direction but reverse direction, that landing width also minus 1.5 meter. Okay, now what we'll do, this inclined beam will rest this beam, so this beam also inside this node. So copy this node, Control C, Control V, that is X direction but reverse direction. So what we'll do, minus 0.2 meter. Okay, same way, select this node, Control C, Control V, that is right direction, so 0.2 meter. Okay, now what we'll do, we connect this node and this beam rest wheel, the first floor beam. So take add beam and connect this node. Now what we'll do, we'll provide here our step by add 4 noted plates. So select this node and we take first this node and this middle node, this node and this node. Now we'll provide first landing. So select this node, this node, this node and this one node. Same way, we select this node, the middle node and this node. Same way, we'll select this node, and this node. Now see, our first stair work almost done. So what we'll do, we'll check. Now one thing, we provide one beam here. So what we'll do, we delete this beam. So select this one and press delete button. Okay, now see, this is stair by 3D rendered view. See, our stair is, first stair is done. Okay, now go to our second stair and we'll do same way. So this is our second stair. So same way, we'll take first this node, and assuming this first step will start from this column, assuming this distance 1.2 meter. So what we'll do, select this node and Control C, Control V, that is X direction 1.2 meter. Okay, now our first landing is here. So what we'll do, this height will be half height of this column. So select this column and this column and insert node at midpoint. Okay, now connect this node by add beam. Now we'll provide here landing, so that landing with also 1.2 meter. So that direction will be x direction but reverse direction. So what we'll do, select this beam, control C, control V, that is minus 1.2 meter. Okay, now select this beam also and take insert node at midpoint. Okay, now see how much length this 1.252. So select this node, control C, control V, that is z direction will go 1.252. Okay, now we'll create inclined beam here. So what we'll do, so select this node and this node. So control C, control V, that is z direction point, sorry, that is z direction 0.2 meter. Same way select this middle node, this node and this node, control C, control V, and that is z direction but reverse direction, minus 0.2 meter. Okay, now add beam and connect this node and this node, this node and this node. Same way, connect this node, this node, this node to this node. Now what we'll do, same way we'll copy this beam and mirror. So select this beam, this beam, this beam and this beam, and generate mirror node on plane. Select this node and that is xy direction. Okay, now this beam also go downward, but this beam is knit upward and it will connect our ground floor roof beam. So what we'll do, select this beam, control this beam, and same way generate mirror node on as previous node, and this beam is not required here. So what we'll do, move, and that is xz direction. Okay, now what we'll do, this beam rest on this beam, and that is from this node to 0.2 meter inside. So what we'll do, select this node, control C, control V, that is z direction but reverse direction, so put minus 0.2 meter. Okay, now add beam, connect this node and this node. Now see, this beam length and this beam length will be same. So what we'll do, select this beam and see how much length, 0.852. so same, thus select this beam, control C, control V, that is this beam will come z direction but reverse direction, and this distance 0.852. so put this value minus 0.852. okay, now we'll draw here. So we'll draw our plate here. So what we'll do, select this node and this node, control C, control V, that landing with also 1.2 meter, that is 0.2 meter. Okay, so what we'll do, now we connect the node by add four knotted plates. So select this one, this node, this node, and this node. One thing, our this inclined step go outside from this node. So what we'll do, select this node, control C, control V, that is Z direction, and this is our X direction, this is our Z direction, and this is, that is reverse direction, so minus 0.2 meter. Okay, now what we'll do, once again add four nodded plate. So select this node, this node, this middle node, and this node. Same way, select this node, this node, this node, this node, and now take this node, this node, this node, and this node. Now our this second stair also done. Now see, here we provide one beam here, so this beam is not required here, so what we'll do, delete this beam. Okay, another one thing, we provide here our intermediate beam to raise this landing, so not required this beam, so delete this beam. Now see by 3D rendered view, let's see. Now see, this is our first stair, and this is our second stair. Okay, done. Go model. Now one thing, we'll create one group for stair, which help us to during the assign the property. So for this, what we'll do, go to tools and create new group, or we'll directly control G. So select this one and group name, considering our, let's write steer, STAIR, steer, and select type, node will be beam. Okay, now here we can see steer beam unassigned, so what we'll do, select this steer beam. So first thing, we select this beam, this beam, this beam, this beam, this beam. Same way, select this beam and this beam, this beam, and sorry, this one also selected, so deselect this one. Okay, now go to our second stair. So control, select this beam, this beam, this beam, this beam, this beam, this beam, and associate to view, associate to selected geometry, associate to list. So what we'll do, associate to list, then associate to selected geometry, associate. Now see, this list are show here. So now see, beam assigned. Same way, create another, that is step landing. So that is right step node plate. Okay, So what we'll do, we'll assign our step plate. So go to not cursor and select the plate. Select this one, this one, this one, and this. And this one, same way, select this one, this one, this one, and this one. Now associate to selected geometry, associate. Now list is show here, so close this one. Now go to our whole structure. Now we will define our material properties. So let's go general and define. First we select our column properties. So go tapered I. Now assume our exterior column 300 by 5 mm and 200 by 6 mm. So 0.3005 mm, 0.3, 0.2 meter, and 0.006. Now this top flange and width of top flange and width of bottom flange are same, as well as thickness of top flange and thickness of bottom flange are same. So that's why not put the value. Step pro take automatically this value. So add. This is our exterior column. Now we'll put interior column. Interior column assume 305 mm, 5 mm, 208 mm. So 305 mm, 208 mm. Add. Now we'll put exterior x direction beam, that is assume 300 by 5 mm and 150 by 6 mm. So 305 mm, 300, and that is 150, that means 15 and 6 mm. Add. Now assume z direction 450 by 5 mm and 150 by 8 mm. So 450 by 5 mm and 150 by 8 mm. So 150 by 8 mm. Now add. This is our exterior column, this is our interior column, this is our x direction beam, this is our z direction beam. Now we'll define our landing beam. Assume the landing beam properties size 255 mm and 156 mm. So 255 mm, 156 mm. Add. Now we'll define the material size of subbeam. Assume the subbeam size 255 mm and 156 mm. So 255 mm, 255 mm, and 125 6 mm. Add. Let's, maybe I have mistake on mistake. Close this section. 250, this also will be 250 250. Change. Close. Now this is our exterior column, this is our interior column, this is x direction beam, this is z direction beam, this is landing beam, this is sub beam. Now we'll assign, define our, here we provide checker plate, that thickness, and also define the RCC slab thickness. So go to thickness. First, this is our steel plate. The thickness 0.006 mm. Add another, we assume concrete, that thickness 100 mm, that means 0.1 mm, 1 meter. Add. Now we also provide pipe bracing, so go to section database and we'll provide pipe. So go to Chinese section, so go to pipe, view tables, and our pipe diameter 127, 4 mm thickness. So select this one. Now it show here, close. Now we'll define our property. So first we are assigned our column. So select beam parallel to y axis. Now show our vertical column and right click, new view. Okay, go to top view. Now there is no anything show here, so what we'll do, shift press K. Now node is show here. So first thing, we are provide exterior column, this exterior column property, and then select, go once again top view and select this column, this column and this column, and go to isometric view. Now all exterior column are selected. Assigns to selected beam, assign, yes. Now go to interior column. Now select by this way, control this one and this one. Assign to selected beam, assign, yes, assign. Now our all column assign, and go to whole structure. Now we'll assign X direction beam, so select X direction beam, and same way go to Z view and select top beam and right click, new view. Okay, go to isometric view, go to top view and select the beam, select this beam. I have one thing I'm just inform, this beam and this beam is not required because this is double height. So first we delete this beam. So select this beam, control this beam, and same way this beam, assign to selected beam, assign, yes. Now we'll assign our Z direction beam. So select this beam, select this beam, and select this beam, assign to selected beam, assign, yes. Now see, now we will define our landing beam. Our landing beam is 5. So Control G and select the stair beam, select and highlight and cross. Now assign to selected beam, assign, yes. Now same way, select, we'll assign the plate thickness. So select this plate thickness, same way control G, and step plate assign highlight close. Assign to selected plate, assign yes. Now we will assign our sub beam, so 6 our sub beam. So what we will do, select by missing attribute by missing properties. Now see here, sub beam is show here. One thing, this is not our sub beam, so deselect this beam this way. Sorry, very carefully. Okay, same way we deselect this beam. Control and this beam, this beam, this beam, and this beam. Now see, all sub beam are selected. Now assign to selected beam, assign yes. Now this beam are missing, so our x direction beam is 3, so select this beam once. Select this beam, same way, select this beam, control, now assign to selected beam, assign, yes. Now see, select by missing attribute, missing property, no entity with missing property is found. Okay, now we'll define our plate, so our slab. So what we'll do, we'll take add four noted plate. So select this node, this node, this node, and this node. Same way, select this node, this node, this node, this node, select this node, this node, this node, and this node, select this node, this node, this node, and this node. Same way, select this node, this node, this node, and this node, select this node, this node, this node, this node, so select this node, this node, this node, and this node. Same way, select this node, this node, this node, and this node, select this node, this node, this one, 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 this one. Now all slab are selected. So go to general and first select the concrete plate thick, sorry, this is steel, this is concrete. And now go to plate cursor, select this one, control, this one, 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 and this one. Now assign to selected plate, assign, yes. Now we'll see this whole structure by 3D rendered view. So see, all thing are assigned. Okay. Now one thing is missing, not assigned here, that is pipe. So we'll provide the bracing. So we provide bracing this portion, this portion, this portion, and this portion. So what we'll do, take first, select this beam and insert node at midpoint. Okay, so take add beam, this node to this node, this node to this node, same way, this node to this node, this node to this node. Now select this beam and do you want to add node here? Yes, add midpoint. Okay, select this node and this node, same way, this node and this node. Now go to geometry zones, sorry. We also provide this pipe bracing. So what we'll do, but here is one node, so we cannot take midpoint. So what we'll do, take this dimension and this node to this node, that is 5.75 meter. So what we'll do, 5.75 divided by 2, that means 2.875. so we'll take this node, control, select this node, control C, control V, that is Z direction, 2.875. okay, now add beam, select this node, this node, this node, and this node. Now we'll define this material. So first of all, select these properties, that is pipe, and select by missing attribute, missing properties. Now all pipe bracing are missing, so assign to selected beam, assign, yes. Now all thing are done. Now go to whole isometric view, go to jet view, and we'll increase, we'll add more story. So what we'll do, select all members, all beam, and also here we put the plate, so select that plate also. So what we'll do, select this plate cursor and go to control, press control A, that also plate also selected. Now go to transitional repeat Y direction. So let's see how much height, our first floor height, 3.140, but this height is lower than of our ground floor height. So what we'll do, first of all we provide our ground floor height. So put Y direction, that is 3.673 Y direction. Okay, now select our select node cursor, select all node and right button click and move. And how much we'll go down, let's check. our ground floor height was 3.673 minus our first floor height 3.19. That means, sorry, 3.673 minus how much height our ground floor? 3.14. Sorry, 3.14. 3.14. 0.533. So we'll reduce minus 0.533. Okay. Yes. Now see height is okay or not. Now 3.14. Now it's okay. Now go to hold structure and go to isometric view. Sorry, 3D rendered view. Now see, everything is okay. Now we will provide slab here because it was double story height, so we'll provide connect this beam as well as provide sub beam and plate, and also provide the roof stair. So let's see. So connect this beam, this one, and this one, and this one, and go to Z view, select top beam, go to new view, okay, isometric view. Now we'll provide here the sub beam. So this distance and this distance are same. So what we'll do, we check how much length of this 1.4375. So same way we'll provide, select this beam, control C, control V, that is Z direction. We'll select, go to transitional repeat, that is Z direction, and distance 1.4375, and step will be 3. So 1, 2, 3. Okay, now say sub beam. Now sub beam is are show. Now we'll provide plate here. So go to add four noted plate, select this node, this node, this node, and this node, and select concrete plate thickness, and go to plate cursor, select this one, assign to selected plate, assign, yes. Now see, one second, 3D. Oh, another one thing, we not define our material properties, this beam. So this is our X direction beam. Our X direction beam was 3, so select this one and select this also. So assign to selected beam, assign, yes. And Z direction beam is 4, so select this one and select this, sorry, this, assign to selected beam, assign, yes. Now select this sub beam, this sub beam, and this sub beam. So sorry, our sub beam is 6 is our sub beam. So select this one, this one, and this one, assign to selected beam, assign, yes. Now all member are assigned. One second, check by select missing attribute, missing properties, no entity with missing properties found. Okay, now once again let's go whole structure, Z view, and select this beam and go to new view. Okay, isometric view, top view. Now we will provide our ground floor, sorry, roof stair layout plan. Now see, this is our roof layout plan. So select this portion, select this select this beam, select this beam, and select this beam. Also select this beam, this beam, this beam. And right click, new view, okay. Go to isometric view. Now select this one, select this one, whole thing are selected. Also select this one and transitional repeat, y direction, how much height of roof height, 3.19. So put the value 3.19. Link step, okay. Now this column is not required, so delete. So delete this one, this one, this one. So delete. Now we provide beam here, so add beam, this one and this one. Also provide sub beam here, so add by the this node and this node, this node and this node, this node and this node. Now we'll define, before define assign the property, we also delete this column. Also delete this column, delete this column, and also add this node by beam. Now we provide one beam here, so select this one and insert node at midpoint, okay. Now see how much distance here, 1.252. so select this node, control C, control V, that is Z direction, 1.252, okay. Now let's check 1.252, okay. Now add these two node by beam, select this node, this node. Now we'll assign the property. So what we'll do, select, this is our exterior column, this one, this one, this one, only this beam, only this beam and this beam will new column. So select this column, sorry, first of all our exterior column was 1, so select this column, this column, sorry, select this column, this column, and this column. Assign to selected beam, assign, yes, same way. This is our interior column, select this one, this one, this one. Assign to selected beam, assign, yes. Now we provide our x directional beam, this one, and this is already selected, this also, this is assign, define it also, R6, it also define. Now our x direction beam is 3, so select this beam, assign to selected beam, assign, yes. Now 6 is our sub beam, so select this one, this one, this one, and this one. Assign to selected beam, assign, yes. Now see if anything missing or not. Select by missing attribute, missing properties. This beam is not assigned, that is Z direction, and Z direction is our 4. So select this one and this one, assign to selected beam, assign, yes. Once again check select by missing attribute, missing properties, no entity with missing properties found. Now we'll provide the slab here, this also, this also. So take add node, this node, this node, this node, this node, same way, this node, this node, this node, and this node. And this is RCC, so plate thickness concrete, plate cursor, select this plate, control, select this plate, assign to selected plate, assign, yes. Now go to whole structure and see our, see the whole structure by 3D rendered view. Now see, now everything is okay. Now see, go to our full structure and check once again. Structure, full section, apply, close. One thing, just I show you our, go to layout plan. This is our Z direction column. All column are Z direction. But here, or all column X direction. So what we'll do, we create beta angle, create beta angle 90 degree, okay. Now select all beam, beam parallel to Y axis. Before that select the property and go to select beam parallel to Y axis and in assign to selected beam, assign, yes. Now see, structure, full section, apply, close. Now see, now column is Z direction. This beam is something wrong. So let's check, go to geometry. This beam is our Z direction. So our Z direction beam is, this is our Z direction beam. So check this one. Yes, I have mistake here. This is 450 and this also will be 450. So 45. Chains, close. Now check once again, structure, full section, apply, close. Now see, this beam is okay. Now one thing, our column is okay, but